Today we're gonna do armbar for mount. So Latif, come here please. Put your head there. Yeah. So look, first I'm gonna go over how I learned armbar for mount in the beginning. Look, I would be always trying to isolate one arm. So in the past, I would try, that's how I was being taught. I would push the elbow slightly on the side and then use my ribs to push it to the center line. And then from here, I would go for the head or maybe the gift wrap. Start going for the elbow, go higher, circle up, see, and start going for armbar here. And not necessarily wrong, but the problem is this. In the past, people always been told, and in one sense it's right, then to never show your back, right? So if you roll to your belly, see, yeah, go back, see? That would be bad, obviously, but not entirely, because the moment you turn, see, you can get here, see, and you can get make space between this knee. Now, as long as you keep, see, look, if I start pulling the arm sideways, see, and the only way I'm gonna get armbar is he fights that rotation. See, if I'm here with my ribs and you rotate back out if please, see, and I block it, then it stops his rotation. But the thing is, if I block my his elbow on this side, he can still roll to that side. And he can say I will have the back, but these days back defense is not that easy anymore. Because I will make a good system about it. So, in the middle please, yeah. So, in the past, the only reason that this kind of armbar works is because people are very afraid of giving their back, they fight the rotation, stay in the middle, and then this armbar works. But now the problem, look, if you start defending like this, imagine I put the elbow on this side, you're gonna do the Turkish get up. Even if I get here, Turkish get up, yeah, that's my mount defense. It goes very hard to do this armbar. Pump it down, please, yeah. On top of this, another thing that can stop you from doing this armbar is even if I get all the way in here, see, and if I don't control, even if I control the elbow, I don't control the head, see, start walking backwards, yeah. Then you can slip out or go back, make a bridge. If it bridges, the same thing happens. So let's go back again. So we have to address those things. So every time when I get into mount, the first thing I try to do is to make sure, well, it goes step by step. So usually I come from like the mermaid pass, I come into mount and I start blocking his feet with my feet. I made two hooks. I will show from different angle later. And I start by unhooking one arm. Yeah, if I can do both, it's even better. It really depends. So it depends how we got in. So close your elbows, please. So let's say we're here, we got double underhooks. See? And then from here, I start. See, block it really, please. Yeah, good. Now I start walking my hand forward and trying to open the elbow. Together with this, if I put my weight too much forward, what if bridge, please? See? Then it becomes a problem. See? So I have to hook my feet and drag myself actively backwards. Now bridge. Now it's a difference, you see? Okay. Then I start in the beginning, so close your elbows. Yeah. I have to make sure I never put my elbows close and too close to his ear, because if he slowly bridges this side, slowly bridge, and stop, see, stop. I will wrist lock myself. So in the beginning, keep tight. Yeah. If I can reach his head, I will take it. If I cannot, I will ignore it for now. So try to walk away with it. I have to stop him from walking away all the time. So I can hook with my head, walk away, and it becomes harder. Now, keep your elbow closed, open my hand and start walking forward. Resist a bit, yeah, here, walk. At the same time when you walk, you close your elbow, it's not really the walking, like the walking makes put my hand a little bit further, but the main thing that opens his elbow, keep resisting, is the push forward with my body, see, and I keep walking, until I control the head. See, once I control the head, I pull it sideways. Try to bridge now, the other side, hey, you can do, bridge, see, you can still bridge. But it can only go on one side because I control the head. Control the, block the elbow again. Then I start walking on this side. See, and the same thing. If I get this point, see, I can lift the head and I control both arms and the head. See, once I lift his head from the floor, make a bridge please. Yeah? It becomes very hard for him to bridge. If I lean forward, he can still do it. But if I keep pulling myself backward, now go for it, that's way harder. Now, if I have this grip, I can still choose to do the same from last week, then I put my head outside, put some pressure, and even let go of one arm and do the arm triangle or a regular triangle. But for today, I'm going to do the arm bar. So I push forward, and like always, what I initially do always is put my head on the outside and add some pressure to their face. See, so when I rotate, I'm going to rotate in, see, and start like cooking them for a while. Resist it, please, Ali. Yeah. Okay, good. Now, what I feel, if he keeps his head, his chin up, keep the rock bottom, see? If I cannot lift his head, I will not go for the arm, but I will keep here, I will keep crossing him, let's say. And the moment he pushes it back when I feel the head relaxed, I will lift it up. When I relax, when I lift it up, see, now I try to bridge, it becomes quite hard, see, if I lift the head up. And on this moment, I'm going to use my left leg in this case. I'm going to slide as far forward as I can. Try to move a little bit. At the same time, to make sure I keep my weight in the center. So, fight a little bit here. And, well, you wait and fight a bit until it relaxes. Once he relaxes, I'm going to go forward my legs, lift him up, and then put my other foot on the floor and go to the Z mount. So do it again from the other side. Put your head on that side. Like here. So again. And I will show how I get in here in a second. But now close the elbows. Yeah. So here, hook the legs. Pull your hip backwards towards your feet. Close the elbows. Yeah. Now start walking. At the same time, push forward until little by little I can reach his head and then pull it sideways. Try to get your arm out now, try to move. It's gonna be hard. Do the same thing on the other side. Keep walking. The second side is usually easier. And now I'm gonna wrap up his head and his arm. See, this, in the beginning I use my right arm to lift his head and then the left one comes underneath. And now with my left arm, I'm in his armpit on this side. I will also show that side in a second. And here, see, try to get out of it. So once I control this, I don't need my right arm and hand anymore to wrap it up. My left arm is enough. So here, try to move relatively. It's going to be hard. So now from here, I'm going to slide forward, post on the floor, and pull him up, and then go to Z-mount. Normally in Z-mount, I'm going to put the toes. I have very unflexible toes, so I cannot really do that. Now, let's go for another angle, one more time, right on that side. Here, we hook the legs, close your elbows, start walking, push, keep walking little by little until you control the head. If his arm gets stuck like this, I can push it out of my shoulder, then wrap both up. So then here the most important thing is to keep the arms tight again. So try to move a little bit. Yeah. And here, just take your time. You got plenty of time here. So try to bridge. If you bridge it, you wait, and it relaxes, then you slide your knees forward and lift them up. So you try to move a little bit. It's a very tough position. So you can still bridge, yeah. But my hand kind of stops it. And if I lift his head, it's even better. So now I'm going to go take a step and just little by little go into my Z mount. Now, once we're here, it depends where his arm is. Let's now make it easy for a second first. Switch your hands. That would be stupid, but let's go to that one first. So here, the first thing I want, every time his head goes on the floor, you can bridge and start walking away. So I want to control that head. So you try to do an alative. Yeah. My arm alone is not enough. Put your head down. Yeah. Relax. So I was going to try to lean in a little bit. So try to do it now. Now it's harder. Now, once I'm here, I'm going to post my right hand on the floor. I'm going to put my right leg up, left leg up, and I can block his head still from here. Now, I will go for the arm. And usually the common thing that people say is to drop backwards for an arm bar. What I do, however, see at this point, see I let go of the head. See? I'm going to put my tibia in his face. If I step over, there's always a chance he's going to put his arm inside. So I don't see any reason why I would ever step over his head at this point in the technique. Now, at this point, we have to see where is Latif bridging. Let's say you do the baby bridge to that side. No, other side. Yeah. So this would be the easy one. Now, if I'm here and I would fall backwards, then Latif can scoop to the other side and his arm will be escaping. So what I gotta do here, see, is to go forward, see, to bend your arm, please, Latif. Yeah. And I, instead of pulling the arm, see, I'm actually gonna push my hip forward. So baby bridge this side. Yeah, see, this is the easy version. See, then I'm gonna go with, I just use my hip to push the elbow in the right spot. So when I do an arm bar, I don't see it like this. I don't see it, block the elbow, yeah, relax it. Yeah. I don't see the arm bar as me pulling the hand backwards. No, I see it as me blocking the hand, see, and pushing the elbow forward. So resist it, okay? See, this is pretty hard, but resist this. Feel the difference?
Yeah.
It's still hard, but if you use your hip to push the elbow in, the hip is the strongest part. If you use your hip to push the elbow in the correct spot, then it's way easier. So the main thing that I try to get is to wrap the hands and the head together. Here, use one, then in the end, you can put your head, so you can open his elbow at this point. The grip in the shoulder resists the opening a little bit. But just a little, so open your elbow a little bit. I can block it, see, and use my head to keep it wrapped together. It's like an arm triangle just with both arms. You squash him, when you feel him relax, you go forward, you slide your knee forward, step, lift him up, and really make sure his head cannot touch the floor. And you wait here for a while. Let's say his arms are switched, you do the other one in a second. You hug the elbow, instead of pulling backwards, you're gonna lean forward, see? Post, put your weight on your right hand, my hand on the other side here, put my tibia in his face, and from here I'm gonna go forward, see? And start extending my hip. See, bend your arm, please. See, instead of, see, resist that. If I pull, that's hard, but resist this. Just use my hip, and it goes. Let's say he starts to come up towards me, so rotate, he starts to come up. Keep going, see? I still control his head with my shin. So that is important. Try to lift your head a little bit. Yeah. At the very least, if I keep his head on the floor like this, he's more trapped. And also have to take one thing less into account. Here he can only lift his hip. Try to lift your head. That makes it hard. And if he does lift his head, go. See? He can always rotate, see? And attack the Americana from this side. Rewind, please. But usually what I want to do... No, stay here. Yeah. Usually what I want to do at this point, see, bring your hand backwards. It's all about his elbow here. If his elbow goes away, then he can start circle towards me, on this side, and get the elbow out. Go back. Yeah. So what I got to do here is make sure the elbow really stays tight to my body. I don't really care about the arm, it's the bottom arm. I only want to have the elbow. And from here, I'm going to start stretching. Feel the shoulder?
Yeah.
Once this is out, I'm going to use my arm. So the arm that wraps his arm, I'm going to put it over my leg and post my opposite arm. So my right arm posts in this case. I'm going to put my head closer and I'm going to start rotating here. Now you can hide his arm at this point. That complicates things a bit. But in the beginning, see, I'm going to teach it without in the beginning. I'm going to keep the elbow. So you're not trying to fight this Latif. See? So it's here like a baby to the scoop again. If Latif stays as he is, see, I'm going to go closer and start taking the arm in this direction. Latif, walk away from me, please. Latif starts to walk away. I'm gonna go belly down again. Not completely belly down, because then he can slip out, but like belly down in a turtle. See, I go here. Should Latif go up at this point, see, I can block it, and should he circle towards me, see, I can always rotate, go for a triangle, or attack the Americana. Let's go again. Right here. So the main thing I want to teach is the entry. On top, you can still choose whatever you do if you prefer dropping. But for me, this is the favorite way to do. So I go over, so put the feet in the beginning, double unders, close your elbows, yeah, start walking forward, hinge the head, walk the second one forward, lift the head up, and wrap them both up. Block the elbow, put your head sideways, go back, and now you can start using the shoulder of justice for a while. Maybe you tap him, maybe you just control and make him tired. And then when you feel he relaxes his neck, you're gonna slide the left arm wrap. So my left knee is gonna slide forward. So post the foot, lift him up. And now I close my, it's like a triangle that I don't close. But around the moment, the most important thing is he cannot put his head on the floor anymore. Like here he can still bridge, one second. Here he can still bridge. So it's rather a fast motion, and one time when you get here, you have to lean back, post hand on the floor, and still control his head. And then from here depends, see? The way he is right now, see, I would start attacking this arm. There's a few options you can do. You can go here, and it always depends on his baby. If his baby is away, yeah, here. So try to look at this, there you go. I can still block that, and as you go to the other side, see? And I can immediately start attacking the arm on this side. But, go back. There's a third option, which I prefer. So just like this with leg locks, when you want to attack the legs, you have to control both legs. So one arm, one leg is used to, one leg you have to attack to tap, and the other leg is gonna use to escape, the secondary leg. The same with arms. You have control both of his arms, it's very hard for him to escape. So he tried to rotate, because by lifting this arm up, I stop the rotation to that side, and the same, he rotated away. His arm is stuck, so he cannot rotate to that side. So what I often do here, if he leans into me, I start threatening by turning over, by going here. And I just give it some time. And when he switches the other side, see, that's when I start dropping, I go over and control both of his arms. In this case, I will cross my feet and pull my heels in. See? And what I will work now, here really depends on this, I can give like a whole, I have a whole DVD about this position actually. But initially what I try to use, so is to get the arm on my shoulder, and I can finish with this armbar first. See? So how to finish? You put pressure on the elbow, put both hands together, you push the elbow down, I go forward, and then I arch my back. This either works or it reacts. Now, people think that this army will be easy to attack, but if I go here, in the moment I pull out these baby bridges, he slides the elbow out. So what I usually do here is I'm here, I start attacking this arm. See, and how you can defend it at the same time is by rotating a little bit in. See, by do the baby bridge, please. See here. Go back. Yeah. So baby bridge. That side is, yeah, see. As it goes, see, go. That's when I rotate over and will attack on this side. And then you can still defend it, of course, here. And that will lead us too far now. So then we're gonna then have to explain the whole arm bar. Another important thing is, in the past, they would teach me, today we're gonna do arm bar from close guard. That is arm bar from mount, arm bar from side control. For me, it really helps to see the whole position as so arm bar as one thing, the 360 arm bar. And now I just happen to have an entry from top. Now the alternative that I can use to attack is if I don't get the double underhook, I like to do. I also have to control the head for the simple reason that otherwise he can bridge and run away. And now, if Latif puts his head on the floor like strong, so you keep it tight, see, and I get here, it will be very hard for me to lift it up. So what I do in this case, I put my hand in his armpit, start digging it in, start walking, and bring my elbow up. See, now it's like how you call this, like a half Nelson. See, he's fight go. It's a good control, and this usually also leads. If you go in, see, to a triangle attack, which I actually will explain because I got an interesting detail from there. So when you walk, put your hand inside, go deep, and now, see, by using your arm as a lever, you can turn into his side. Start walking forward, post. It's like an upright Z mount. Now what is interesting, look, this arm. So I'm gonna push forward, and often when people roll it back to me, see, that's the moment I'm gonna step my leg inside. But look, the interesting thing is I'm not going to take this arm away. Because my game is often baiting a triangle, giving it an escaping from top. And it all depends on your head being free. Now look at this, if I keep my arm here, Latif comes on top, see? And I step over my own arm and triangle like this, you try to move. It's much tighter, there is less space. And see, I can tap him here. And at the same time, you try to lift your head up, Latif. See, the head is really stuck. So try to stack me. It's harder, right?
Yeah.
So this is something that really made my triangle way better. So the video is about the armbar from mount and the triangle variation. So we have both. Come back here. So once again. So let's say we came from a double leg. We do the Khabib pass that I showed a few weeks ago, the mermaid pass. Go up. And you can hear start putting pressure on me. Put pressure. And the main key here is to always put pressure. See? Is to keep your position, keep your hip tight, head high, push, see? And just be insistent. Keep your pressure little by little. And this can take a while, see? If he pushes my head away, see? I'm mostly, I keep pushing, rotating back to the center so he cannot get me away. I can try to get his arm low, but the idea is mainly to keep constant pressure forward. Keep tight. Once I get the both shoulders, I can start sliding in. Just be very patient with this. And I start climbing the ladder. If I can keep his leg stretched out, try to move, that's even better right now. If he gets it up, then he can bridge again. Keep tight. Okay. And once I get here, I like to stay low, because the higher I get, the more chance he can bridge me. So I stay low, and then start opening those elbows. Resist a bit. Go. Catch both arms, open, go forward. And that's what you need. See from here, keep tight. I cannot open, but if I bring myself forward, now I can start attacking one arm. Resist a bit. Yeah. Baby bridge, I try to fight a bit. Grab the head. Forward. Bridge, please, I think. Yeah. The bridge is the main thing I've got to stop. If I put my head down, then I will fly. Go back. If I keep my head up, go now. I have more pressure on my hip. He can't. Keep walking. Lift the head up. See, wrap together. You can still complicate things. See how I keep your head on the floor? Open your elbow. See, so don't allow me to lift the elbow. He can complicate it like that. So in that case, he can start putting pressure on the throat for a split second, or try to dig and keep resisting. Try to dig underneath the head itself. And in that case, I go for this grip. So no, keep resisting. I try to go for the grip in the armpit I just showed. And I can still combine. You could continue for the armbar or go for a triangle or stay on the pad that you were. Control. K. keep tight, held on the outside, walk forward. And this is a rather fast motion, I'm not too detailed about it. So from here I go forward, see, and lift it up right away. So you try to move here, stuck. It's like a clinch, like a stack. From here, knee to the floor, post your hand, rotate around him, and your head can be used to block it, but only so much. I prefer really to use my hand and start attacking the arm. Okay. Go forward first. Only if he locks his arm together, like the opposite, like this, then this one, I start going for the leg and go down, because I find it easier to open the arm from here. And if he, like I said in the past, if he puts his hands different like this, I try to go for this arm bar, and as a defense, by bridging, see? That's what I will go over, see? And you roll it to the other side. This is my version of the arm bar for mount. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. And be sure to check out the full mount series so far. It actually started with half guard, where we did the mermaid sweep first. And on top, we went crawl slowly up to the high mount, where we have the triangle, the arm triangle, and now the triangle variation and the arm bar variation.